Winner of the Heisman Trophy is Devontae Smith.
Michigan has to cancel its game at Ohio State this weekend.
CC has announced the football season will feature one division, and it will include the Fighting Irish.
College football, a sport that is fueled by passionate fans, upsets, rivalry games, ranking systems, and bowl games. What if I told you there was a college football season in history that lacked passionate fan bases at college games, some rivalry games, and even the sure thing that there was even going to be a college football season? And that season would be none other than the 2020-2021 college football season. So to start out with this season, let's really talk about the offseason first. As usually, you know, the offseason for college football is a long time, but we always have two things to keep us busy, and that's the spring game / spring camp and media days. And we all know how important spring games are to college football because there's such a long layoff between the start time of college football and the end time of college football. And that's just the one bit of college football we get in between that. And this will also mean fall camp not happening. And we all know fall camp and spring camp are pivotal in college football, as, you know, true freshmen that's coming in get the first bit of reps in practice. And with all the offseason stuff being canceled, it was really uncertain if the season was really going to happen or not, as the season was slated to start on August 29th, but that didn't happen. But thankfully, the ACC, SEC, and Big 12 and other small group of five conferences said, okay, we'll start football in September. And the plan was to have all these teams just play conference games, and this led to Notre Dame choosing to play the ACC this season. And this will be the first time in 100 plus years that Notre Dame wouldn't be an independent team. Even though the plan was to play all conference games, the ACC and Big 12 allowed at least one non-conference game, but the only thing is, it had to be an in-state opponent. But conferences such as the Big 10, Pac-12, the MAC, Mountain West, and several other independent schools aimed to start the season in spring of 2021. Instead of starting the season in spring of 2021 for those conferences, though, they just decided to shorten the season. But teams such as Old Dominion, UConn, and New Mexico State just decided to opt out the whole season.
LSU wide receiver Ja'Marr Chase is opting out of the 2020 season.
And teams weren't the only ones opting out, as you had players opt out that season also. According to Salt Lake Tribune, by the time of mid-late September, you already had 150 college football players opt out of the season. Future first-round picks Penei Sewell, Ja'Marr Chase, Caleb Farley, and Micah Parsons will all opt out that season. And remember earlier when I said fans were important in college football? Well, that was going to be limited this season. Conferences like the ACC, SEC, and Big 12 and other small conferences would allow fans, but it will only allow the stadium to fill up to 25% capacity. So stadiums will only fill up to at least 16,000 to 25,000 people. And when the Big 10 and Pac-12 announced that they were starting their season, but it was just going to be a shortened season, they also said there was going to be no public attendance for that season, but family members was going to be allowed to attend the game. So we weren't going to get a Penn State versus Michigan moment like one of the previous years. So instead of fans, plenty of Big 10 and Pac-12 schools had just cardboard cutouts in the stands. And some stadiums had nothing. Now let's jump more to the season, as the first college football game of the season was actually UAB versus Central Arkansas, and UAB will win 45-35. And the next week, ACC schools will start playing, as Iowa State got upset by Louisiana 31-14, and this was Iowa State team led by Brock Purdy. And just 2 weeks later, we had SEC play start up, and Alabama would dominate Missouri, and that was the start of their dominant season. But now I want to jump to October 24th, and that was week 8 of the season, and that was an important part of the season.
On 31, but Mertz wants to throw it. He's going for the end zone, caught, touchdown!
And week 8 was when college football for the Big Ten started. And on Friday, Graham Mertz will have a great game against Illinois, where he just completely demolished them. I mean, he played so good, he had Patrick Mahomes tweeting about him that night, and Wisconsin fans thought he was a future star. But it's safe to say that didn't happen. And on Saturday, we got a great moment from a future NFL draft pick.
Steps in.
And if you followed that college football season, you probably remember Michael Penix Jr. lighting the college football world on fire, as his first five games were super great, including the Ohio State game where he nearly threw for 500 yards and had five touchdowns. And if you remember, he's in Heisman talks, but sadly his season got cut short due to an injury. Also that week, you had BYU beating Texas State, and you had Coastal Carolina beating Georgia Southern. And this was Coastal Carolina's first year ever being ranked. Cincinnati would beat SMU, and this proved that they were a for real team, because SMU was also a ranked team, and this would make Cincinnati jump up to number 7 in next week's AP poll. and you fast forward 2 weeks later to November 7th, you will see that not many things change. BYU, Coastal Carolina, and Cincinnati will all stay undefeated. Then you have Florida beating Georgia, and they will look like they were a good team again. And the college football playoff race looked like Clemson, Alabama, Ohio State, then Notre Dame. But things will start to get rocky as you had Notre Dame versus Clemson set to face off that week. But Clemson would be without one of the best players in college football as Trevor Lawrence tested positive and had to sit out that game. So they had to go with DJ Uiagalelei, who was a true freshman, but he was a highly coveted true freshman. And if you remember, he started the game before against Boston College, in which he balled out that game too, but most people didn't pay attention to that. So most people's first glance at him was this Notre Dame game. And DJU did not disappoint this game either, having 29 completions for 439 yards and just 2 touchdowns against a good Notre Dame defense. And this game would be a very great game as Notre Dame won 47-40 after Kyron Williams punched it in for a touchdown and then Notre Dame defense forced a stop. And yeah, Notre Dame games are always on NBC, but that wasn't the case for this game. It started out on NBC, but the problem was that it had to go over to USA Network just because Joe Biden had a presidential speech after the presidential election. And after this week, the darling of college football really was Coastal Carolina.
Coastal Carolina University, I accept the Sun Belt's invitation to become its 12th member.
That clip right there was 4 years prior to the 2020 season. Coastal Carolina decided to go from the FCS to the Sun Belt Conference, and I don't think nobody expected this out of them. In their first 2 years in the FBS, they went 3-9 and 5-7. So them being 9-0 entering week 14 of the college football season was a little bit weird. And at the beginning of the season, some people had their doubts.
I just don't believe in the Coastal Carolina Chanticleers this year. Hammer the Red Wolves! Oh!
But as the season went on, lots of people started to buy into this Coastal Carolina team, including College Game Day, as they got their own segment on College Game Day after they went 5-0 and became a ranked team. But they had one more challenge on the road ahead of them to being undefeated, and that was BYU. And heading into that game, BYU was ranked number 8th, and not only that, they were undefeated, and they were led by future NFL quarterback Zach Wilson. And this game was a 2020 classic, and if you watch this game, then you know this game was simply amazing and great for college football. Zach Wilson performed well as he had 19 completions on 30 pass attempts for 204 yards and a touchdown. But Coastal Carolina's run game gashed BYU's defense for 281 yards and 3 touchdowns on the ground. In their halftime, both teams had to be separated as there was some pushing and shoving going on. And this will happen because Zach Wilson threw a pick at halftime and two Coastal Carolina players decided to block him on an interception return, and the BYU players, of course, didn't like it. And in the second half, it was still a good game. Coastal Carolina looked like they was going to sneak out with the win, but Zach Wilson and company still had a chance to go down almost a length of the field and win the game. And they did just that. They had a chance to win the game, but sadly, the clock struck 12. There was no Cinderella ending for them, and they came up just 2 yards short. And normally, games like these are scheduled in normal years of college football, but like I said, this was a weird year, and this game was impromptu. Originally, Coastal Carolina was supposed to play Liberty, who was ranked number 25 in the AP poll, but Liberty had to drop out of the game due to so many of their players testing positive for the virus. And BYU wasn't even scheduled for this week, as this was a bye week really for them. But the Wednesday before the game, Tom Holmo, BYU's athletic director, sent out the equipment truck to go to Myrtle Beach. And that was before the game was even scheduled, as the game wasn't scheduled until the next day on Thursday. But Holmo said that he wasn't going to not play a game because our guys didn't have the equipment. So this all happened because of a canceled game. And canceled games this season was, well, a common thing. Over 100 games were canceled this season or rescheduled this season. And that classic rivalry between Michigan and Ohio State, well, there was no game to play this season because that game was canceled. The last time these teams didn't meet each other in the whole season was 1917. Not only was this game canceled, but as well was Washington-Oregon's rivalry game. It wasn't just regular season games, it was also bowl games, as originally in 2020 it was scheduled to be 43 bowl games that season, but by December 7th it was only 33 scheduled. And the cancellation of the games also led to weird records, as Oregon made the Pac-12 championship game despite being 3-2. And conference championship games that season consisted of two teams that played probably between 5 and 10 games. And one of those games was, well, Clemson versus Notre Dame, the rematch in which Clemson won 34-10. And I feel, of course, the need to mention how dominant Alabama was this season as they were undefeated, but they also had the Heisman winner. Devontae Smith won the Heisman, being the first non-running back or quarterback to win the Heisman Award since Charles Woodson back in 1997. Smith would be so dominant, he had 1,800 yards and 23 touchdowns. Not only that, he also had a return for a touchdown. Smith would help lead Alabama to an SEC championship win, a Rose Bowl win, and a national championship win. But that Rose Bowl game wasn't really an original Rose Bowl game, as usually, you know, the Rose Bowl happens in Pasadena, California, and that Rose Bowl was in Texas. And this would mark the first time the Rose Bowl wasn't played in Pasadena since 1942. Recruiting will also be a little bit tougher this season, as some high schools didn't have a full season, so it was hard to find those players that jump up in the rankings. This season, I think, also led to some teams having outlier seasons. For example, you got Michigan. They went 2-4 this season, but the season afterwards, they went to the college football playoff. The season before, they were 9-4. Jimbo Fisher led Texas A&M to a 9-win season, which was kind of a common thing for them. They usually got around that win mark, but they never really got close to the college football playoffs until that year. Players that played and didn't play in this season were also granted another year of eligibility. Not really a real part of the season, but Marco Wilson threw that shoe and kind of cost Florida a college football playoff spot. So this season almost ended before it even started and had a bunch of canceled games. Limited amount of fans were allowed at stadiums. Some stadiums had no fans at all. And the wide receiver won the Heisman Award. But overall, this season was still good, because if you watched it, you still got to witness greatness.